Americans who sent a message to the world that we have never been just a collection of individuals or a collection of red states and blue states. We are and always will be the United States of America.
More than anything else, I want my candidacy to unify our country, to renew the American spirit and sense of purpose. I want to carry our message to every American, regardless of party affiliation, who is a member of this community of shared values.
There are many who won't agree with every decision or policy I make as president. And we know the government can't solve every problem. I will listen to you, especially when we disagree. And above all, I will ask you to join in the work of remaking this nation the only way it's been done in America for 221 years, block by block, brick by brick, calloused hand by calloused hand. This victory alone is not the change we seek. It is only the chance for us to make that change. And that cannot happen if we go back to the way things were. It can't happen without you, without a new spirit of service.
Well, my view of government places trust not in one person or one party, but in those values that transcend persons and parties.
So let us summon a new spirit of patriotism, of responsibility, where each of us resolves to pitch in and work harder and look after not only ourselves, but each other.
Abraham Lincoln called upon the people of all America to renew their dedication and their commitment to a government of, for, and by the people. Isn't it once again time to renew our compact of freedom?
In this country, we rise or fall as one nation, as one people. Let's resist the temptation to fall back on the same partisanship and pettiness and immaturity that has poisoned our politics for so long. Let's remember that it was a man from this state who first carried the banner of the Republican Party to the White House, a party founded on the values of self-reliance and individual liberty and national unity. And while the Democratic Party has won a great victory tonight, we do so with a measure of humility and determination to heal the divides that have held back our progress.
The first Republican president once said, "While the people retain their virtue and their vigilance, no administration by any extreme of wickedness or folly can seriously injure the government in the short space of 4 years." If Mr. Lincoln could see what's happened in the last 3.5 years, he might hedge a little on that statement. First, we must overcome something the present administration has cooked up, a new and altogether indigestible economic stew. One part inflation, one part high unemployment, one part recession, one part runaway taxes, one part deficit spending, seasoned with an energy crisis. It's an economic stew that has turned the national stomach. Many have seen their savings eaten away by inflation. Many others on fixed incomes, especially the elderly, have watched helplessly as the cruel tax of inflation wasted away their purchasing power. Together, let us make this a new beginning. Let us make a commitment to care for the needy, to teach our children the virtues handed down to us by our families, to have the courage to defend those values and virtues and the willingness to sacrifice for them. These are problems of flesh and blood, problems that cause pain and destroy the moral fiber of real people who should not suffer the further indignity of being told by the government that it is all somehow their fault. We do not have inflation because we've lived too well. The head of a government which has utterly refused to live within its means and which has in the last few days told us that this coming year's deficit will be $60 billion dares to point the finger of blame at business and labor, both of which have been engaged in a losing struggle just trying to stay even. Can anyone look at the record of this administration and say, well done? Can anyone compare the state of our economy when the administration took office with where we are today and say, keep up the good work? Can anyone look at our reduced standing in the world today and say, let's have four more years of this? I believe the American people are going to answer these questions as you've answered them in the first week in November, and their answer will be, no, we've had enough. We also believe it is essential that the integrity of all aspects of Social Security be preserved. We are going to initiate action to get substantial relief for our taxpaying citizens and action to put people back to work. A phased reduction of tax rates would go a long way toward easing the heavy burden on the American people. Have they thought about those who've always had less, especially the minorities? This is like telling them that just as they step on that first rung of the ladder of opportunity, the ladder is being pulled out from under them. That may be the leadership's message to the minorities, but it won't be our message. Millions of Americans find themselves out of work. Millions more have never even had a fair chance to learn new skills, hold a decent job, or secure for themselves and their families a share in the prosperity of this nation. It's time to put America back to work, to make our cities and towns resound with the confident voices of men and women of all races, nationalities, and faiths, bringing home to their families a paycheck they can cash for honest money.
Yes, we can.
We'll find a way to help them get new skills. For those without job opportunities, we'll stimulate new opportunities, particularly in the inner cities where they live.
Yes, we can.
For those who've abandoned hope, we'll restore hope and we'll welcome them into a great national crusade to make America great again.
As Lincoln said to a nation far more divided than ours, we are not enemies, but friends. And to those Americans whose support I have yet to earn, I may not have won your vote tonight, but I hear your voices. I need your help. And I will be your president too. To those who would tear the world down, we will defeat you. To those who seek peace and security, we support you.
We must always stand ready to negotiate in good faith, ready to pursue any reasonable avenue that holds forth the promise of lessening tensions and furthering the prospects of peace.
And to all those who have wondered if America's beacon still burns as bright, tonight we proved once more that the true strength of our nation comes not from the might of our arms or the scale of our wealth, but from the enduring power of our ideals, democracy, liberty, opportunity, and unyielding hope. America, we have come so far. We have seen so much, but there's so much more to do. To restore prosperity and promote the cause of peace, to reclaim the American dream and reaffirm that fundamental truth that out of many we are one, that while we breathe, we hope, and where we are met with cynicism and doubt and those who tell us that we can't, we will respond with that timeless creed that sums up the spirit of a people. Yes, we can. Thank you.
God bless America.
God bless you, and may God bless the United States of America.